Hi, my dear students. Today we will discuss about the business viability. After studying this session, you will be understand the dimension of business viability and explain economic, financial, technical, and market viability. Explain the business model and management viability. Under the dimensions of business viability, we may focus market viability, technical viability, economic viability, financial viability, business model viability, and management model viability. Let's discuss one by one. Under the market viability, the following focuses should be concentrated. First one is market environment. In the market environment, in the sense, the size of the market and the sustainability and the potential market, target market, etc. So the size of the industry, of the business, the business we have planned to start up or the ongoing businesses, we have to determine the size of our business. What is our market share in the industry? And also the sustainability. How far our business is going to sustain? And also in the potential market, in the potential market in the sense even our existing and the future accessibility, that mean capability of the market potential, and also target market, to whom we are going to market our product or services, who will be our target customers. So, and we have to see that viability, whether our business will be commercially viable in terms of the market viability. What is our size, what, how our sustainability, what is our potential market, who is our target customer or customers, like that. Second one, we have to focus the competitors. Who will be the, whatever product or services that we are going to provide, we have to analyze who are the competitors for our business. So we have to have analysis of that competitors. Then only we can compare their pricing policies, product qualities, product strategies, or other strategies in which we also can compete, or we may make it differently from the competitors. So for that we have to analyze the competitors. Then similar products or services, so that also will come even under the competitors. However, we have to analyze what are the similar product and services for our business. Pricing, what is the pricing policies, what type of pricing categories that we focus, so how we are pricing, how the competitors are pricing, etc. Packaging, how would our business focus on the packaging, what is the model, how can we get it, what is the training we may have to have, so then in terms of packaging, so then only we may see the viability of our business. Distribution to the market. How we have to select the distribution, what is the channel, what is the mode, how often it will be carried out, what is the cost for the distribution. So these are the things we have to analyze whether it is viable. The last one, promotion and advertising. What is our advertising policy? How we are going to advertise? What will be the mode of advertising? What is the cost? How often we are going to promote our product or services? What are the mode? What are the type of promotion that we are going to focus? So then whether these are accessible? So then under the market viability, we can focus all of those things. Under the technical viability, we have to measure or plan our capacity. capacity of operations, machineries, the system, the process. So everything we have to do that. Second one, availability of the quality of the resources. That means the raw material, how far the quality is considered to raw material, labor and professional expertise, etc. So quality of the resource. And also in another one, supply chain implications. So how the supply chain will be implied to reach our product to the end customers. Other one is manufacturing process. In the economic viability, first we have to consider the method of investment. So how we are going to invest on the business, and for that we may use the ratios such as return on investment, ROI, need for profit, etc. So we have to calculate the return on investment and need for profit, etc. Second one, cost components. Under the economic viability, we have to consider the cost of production. So how the cost of the variable and also fixed cost, then overall cost of the production, raw material, the cost for the raw material, the cost for the labor, machineries and equipments, and overhead cost, or cost of technology, and cost of marketing. Cost of marketing in the sense, cost of advertising, cost of promotion, cost of research, market research and design. So cost of components. The last one is the ability to generate economic value. So here the scale of economies. So we have to calculate the how we are having the ability to generate our economic value. Under the financial viability, the source of finance. How we are going to finance for our business internally. Source or finance, externally we found the source. Startup cost, how much the startup cost? Most of the companies, the startup cost is very high at the very beginning, since we have to focus the fixed cost in fixed asset. So then we have to first assess. After that we have to consider the viability, to see the financial viability of cash flow. So for example, for a 3 years we have to prepare our projected cash inflow and outflow, then we can see the trend, how far our business will be viable financially. So break-even point, next one, break-even point. So where we may get the, at which point we are going to meet the break-even point, where the cost is equal to revenue. So if the cost lesser than the revenue, so we are not reaching the break even. So at the very beginning period, normally the cost will be higher than the revenue. So to a certain point, the cost will be equal to revenue, where we may call that it is a break even point. So no cost, that means no profit at that point. So beyond that level only we may achieve the revenue. So then we have to see that to which level, to which amount of units we can achieve. So up to that we are going to work, how many years we have to reach that, and after the point produced, then only that will be profitable. So then we can see that whether our business will be financially viable. Likewise, depreciation for a vehicle or of machineries, we have to calculate the depreciation and we can estimate that how far our financially viable viability. Other one is sales and collection of money. Now, what is the projected sales? How we are going to collect the money? What will be the percentage of debt of capital, bad debts, and like that. So we have to estimate. So after then only we may be able to see our financial viability. Business model viability, the uniqueness of the model in terms of the competitive advantages. Last lecture we discussed how the competitive advantages can be derived. So here to get that uniqueness of the model, so in terms of the competitive advantages, we have to differentiate our model, our unique model, than the others, the uniqueness of our model. So that we will say that we are differentiating from the others. Others in the sense other competitors. Other one is ability of the competitor to duplicate. Whether the competitor will duplicate our business idea or business processes. So then ability to create values through priority, knowledge and process. For example, IP, intellectual property. So then ability to create wealth. Whether our business model will be creating the wealth in due course. So then these are the things we have to see whether our business model is viable. The last one is the management model viability. Here we have to see the application of knowledge and skills. Knowledge and skills, whether we can apply the knowledge and skills in our business. So then if it is possible, then we can reach a manage our model is viable. Management model is viable. And also training, whether it is possible to access the training for the particular business. Third one, employee management and training. Are there possibilities to send our employees for their management and training? So some even small companies, small business entities, they send just their employees for some training. For example, corrugated packaging training like that. So IT, information technology training. So other machinery is a special needed equipment training. So now for that we have to see whether our employees can be sent for the management training. In management of risk, next one is ability to delegate to the staff. So if on business, the manager or the owner will be able to delegate the authorities to the staff. Then sustainable organizational structure. So our organizational structure, whether it is changing time to time or it's a fixed or sustainability, it shows the sustainability for a long period. So then that also will indicate the management model viability. Then ability to measure the business process. So whether any business, while they are operating or managing the business, they have to have the ability to measure their business process at the beginning or in the middle or the finally, periodically or as planned, stipulated in the business plan, they may have to measure their business process. So these are the business model viability. So let me summarize once again these viability. So first one is the market viability, and second one technical viability, and third one economic viability, and fourth one financial viability, fifth one business model viability, and management model viability. So then when we after when we are doing our business, or while we are preparing a business plan, we have to see all these business model viability. So then only we will come to know whether our business model will be commercially viable and profitable. Thank you.